first time I ever saw that mutilation thing going on. I saw a lot of things growing up in New York in the 80s. But the first time I really saw somebody up close and personal was in a gas station. I think it was at a Shell gas station in Florida. And this guy, it was as if he had this huge hole puncher that you're trying to put paper in a binder, but just extra large, where it took out half of his ear. And apparently he forgot his earplug. And I had asked him about it. I said, when did he get that done? And he goes, oh, I forgot my stud on there. Yeah, I got the hole there. But yeah, man, isn't it cool? Big chunk of his ear removed. I don't get it. I don't. I mean, I can get people that have tattoos, but geez, mutilating your body. Geez, dear God, isn't there any other thing that you can do with your time? Anything else that you can do to be more productive than do this? I mean, are people really that bored these days, folks? I mean, come on. Anyways, it's a big step for our military, and this is against the Obama. This thing. We have kids that are 4 and 5 operating this thing, and they can figure this stuff out before we do. But you can be right along with them very quickly by watching the video to see how this thing operates. Click, 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 and then you're watching the movie. Get yours now for $19.99 and cut the cable. Stop spending all your money on all of these services when you can just pay one fee for $19.99. You see, folks, a lot of people don't realize this. You may have heard me say this. The stuff already streams on the internet. The problem is you don't know which one to click on, or how is it continuous? Is there 5 or 6, 7 sections that I have to click on where it just is a hassle and more trouble than it's worth? 123 Ready TV. It has the seamless movie commercial-free. Excellent quality, not just mediocre quality, perfect quality. Believe me, you'll want it. Get it now while it's hot. $19.99, 123 Ready TV at ForThePeopleShow.com. You'll love it. Yeah, we get emails all the time, and it's just a beautiful thing. By the way, Catherine Heritage, she is a Fox News correspondent. She's very classy. When you talk about journalism, this woman, I think she gets an A every single time. Classy girl, if you've ever seen Catherine Heritage. But here's her report on Russia right now. This is with meddling and all the stuff that's going on right now in Washington. Catherine Heritage. We're dialing her up right now.
This announcement that Paul Manafort and Donald Trump Jr. will be testifying probably sometime in the early fall. This first panel this morning includes senior Justice Department officials, and they're talking about something called FARA. This is the Foreign Agents Registration Act, and it requires U.S. citizens to register with the Justice Department if they are working on behalf or lobbying on behalf of a foreign government. And this matters because it's one of the issues that in part tripped up former National Security Advisor Mike Flynn, as well as former campaign chairman Paul Manafort, and they had to register retroactively as agents of a foreign government for their work in Turkey and the Ukraine, respectively. The second panel is also of a lot of interest this morning because they have a single expert who has firsthand knowledge and interaction with this Russian lawyer, Natalia Velesnitskaya, who's at the center of the June 2016 Trump Tower meeting with Donald Trump Jr., Jared Kushner, Paul Manafort, as well as others. So it's not as high profile as we were expecting just a couple of days ago, but it's still a central part of the public's understanding of what happened in the election.
So you wonder what they're talking about behind closed doors. So when do we hear from Manafort or Trump Jr., or do we?
Well, the best information we have comes from the senior Democrat on the committee, Dianne Feinstein, who told Fox News late yesterday that they had withdrawn the subpoena for Paul Manafort because he was working with the committee's investigators and operating in good faith to try and get a date on the calendar in early September to publicly testify. And we're also told that's the same time frame they're working with Donald Trump Jr.
All right, Catherine Heritage on Russia. We're going to be hearing from a lot more coming up. Mike Lee from Utah, Brad Blakeman with the Weekly Standard. We got John Thune. He's going to be talking. And let's see, who else do we get? Yep, Senator Mike Lee. So he's back too. And William Lajeunesse too on talking about the border and the crackdown with sanctuary cities, an update there from a correspondent from Fox News, William Lajeunesse, and he's terrific. But what's going on in the crackdown there with sanctuary cities, some action taking place. Their feds are cracking down and going to get these bad hombres out. So if you're in a city and you know you got illegal immigrants that are causing problems and they're the bad ones that need to be getting out, well, you might have some ICE people showing up really soon. They've been employing a lot more and going to clean up your city so we don't have a lot of this human garbage on the streets, unfortunately. And I'm not talking about the ones that are not causing problems. I'm talking about the criminals. So don't send me emails saying that I'm hated on immigrants. It's nothing like that. It's the criminals. They keep on breaking the laws and putting people in danger. Those are the folks that we're talking about here. For the people, remember, we're 100% listener supported. If you like the show, well, we'd like to say share the show. Visit our website today, won't you, at forthepeopleshow.com.
Unlike anything you've ever been through in your life, man. I was driving. This kid threw a grenade at us and went right over our vehicle. It was 12 years old.
The shockwave went through my head, rattled up my brain, and left.
Danger is around you 360 degrees at all times, and you can't unlearn that.
It's impossible to describe the sacrifices these men and women have made to protect our freedoms. And the job of rebuilding their lives is massive and growing every day. Many will need the programs offered by the Wounded Warrior Project for years to come.
I didn't know what PTSD was. All I knew was I was having nightmares. And when I got released, my reintegration was, go check in at the VA, man.
My first coping mechanism was use drugs. Just numb it, don't feel anything.
I was angry. I'm trying to pull myself out of that right now.
Your gift today of $19 per month will honor and empower these veterans so they can aid and assist each other.
The Wounded Warrior Project is a life raft.
I can say this without question, that I wouldn't be here today if it weren't for it.
Wounded Warrior Project is the first step getting back out into the world and reforming yourself outside of the service.
Call or go online with a pledge of $19 a month. You'll receive this Wounded Warrior Project blanket, and your gift will provide critically needed programs that rebuild lives.
That was my first feeling of actually being a part of something bigger than myself again.
Well, I lost a few really close friends overseas, and if I quit, I'm going to let them down, and I'm not about to do that.
I'm learning to face my fears head on.
To trust and see what happens at the end.
It's a long process, but I had the drive and desire.
Please call or go online with your gift right now.
Get ready, get set for 123 Ready TV, the brand new app that everyone's talking about for your PC or Android device that allows you access to most every movie or TV show ever made. Sound incredible? Well, it is, because once you pay $19.99, that's all you pay. Just the movies and TV shows you like without the hassle. The internet streams everything already. What 123 Ready does is it finds them, then delivers them directly to you, commercial free. There's nothing quite like it, and it's available now at ForThePeopleShow.com. That's ForThePeopleShow.com. And before you buy 123 Ready TV, watch the video and see how simple it is to start watching all those movies and TV shows. If you like movies and TV shows, but don't enjoy paying for all of them, no problem. Just pay $19.99 and start enjoying countless titles and entertaining TV better than anyone. Get your 123 Ready TV for $19.99 at ForThePeopleShow.com. Just click on the store page. Some things in life need a little attention. Like a plant. If not watered, it begins to turn brown. But if watered properly, its leaves turn green again. Like a plant, For the People needs watering too. Your thoughtfulness provides sustainability for us to grow and reach our full potential. You see, For the People depends on you to broadcast this program to help inform and educate folks so you can make a difference right where you are. Grab your watering can and join us as we endeavor to make a difference in people's lives each and every day. To donate, go to ForThePeopleShow.com. That's ForThePeopleShow.com. Just look for the watering can and water as much as you can. At For the People, our garden is full of opportunities, and planting something allows others to enjoy the benefits. At For the People, our mission is simple. Give you the news that matters with good old-fashioned common sense, mixed with a conservative point of view. Simply log on to our website at ForThePeopleShow.com. That's ForThePeopleShow.com. Thanks for your support. For the People, back on the air, and I am Keith Allen, and I'm sorry, but no fake news here. We just bring you the truth, and sometimes, folks, the truth hurts, but we love to dish it out, and a good dose of common sense on a daily basis. Love to hear from you. ForThePeopleShow.com is where you can weigh in on our Twitter. You can find our Twitter account there. Talk to Keith Allen or on our Facebook at For the People Show. But I'd love for you to follow us so you can read what we're talking about and kind of be part of our discussion, because that's what it's all about. We know you're talking about it, and we're talking about it too, but your opinion does matter. Not always in Washington, seemingly, and that's kind of a sad thing. So Mike Lee, from Utah, on television today, and we're going to ask him a few questions here. Are you satisfied with how the investigations are going right now, all this Russia stuff?
Yes, today's meeting will be behind closed doors in a classified setting and will be solely for the purpose of collecting documents. I don't expect that we'll learn a lot today except by obtaining documents which we'll then review. But yes, I am satisfied with the fact that these investigations are moving forward, and I think the committees are gaining what they need.
All right, so Mike Lee, let me ask you a question. Manafort, Paul Manafort, and say Donald Trump Jr., are we going to hear from them, say, under oath? A lot of people have been speculating about it. Closed doors, it's going to be an open hearing. What say you?
I think it is quite possible that that will happen. It's just not yet. But I do expect that to happen down the road.
Well, everybody's kind of watching what's going on. But the timeline, people have been talking about that. How long, honestly to goodness? I think there's a huge wear factor. And I'm sure that as this plays on, this plays into the hands, certainly into the Democrats' hands, because they love this stuff going on, because above anything else, you know, the numbers don't look good for Donald Trump. A lot of people that voted for him are really not looking at the numbers, but the approval rating is very low, lower than any recent president in recent memory at that, with 32%. And though, you know, most of his supporters are not looking at so much the numbers, but actually looking at the ultimate outcome, is there a timeline, Mike Lee, on all of this?
I can't imagine that they would go more than another few months because there's just not that much there. As far as I can tell, there's not a whole lot there that's going to lead to a lot of other yet undiscovered topics that will in turn extend the investigation.
All right. You were a no vote, you know, with nine GOP voters last night. You know, what say you about, you know, this health care deal, and a lot of people just down on those that defected and said no?
Okay, I voted yes to get onto the bill yesterday to move forward with a health care debate, We voted last night on an amendment that I disagreed with, one that I thought would unduly, unnecessarily expand government. Yeah. I think the biggest problem we've had with the Affordable Care Act, with Obamacare, has been that it increased the footprint of Washington, D.C., the size, the scope, the power, the cost of Washington, D.C., and it did it in a way that did not bring down the cost of health care to middle-class families. It made it go up. I felt like last night's amendment that we voted on, that I voted against, did too much to increase the size of Washington, not enough to bring down the cost of health care.
All right. Well, Mike Lee, we really appreciate it. Anything else?
The key to getting me to yes is to get as close as possible to a full repeal of Obamacare. And I think one of the things that we need to remember is that 2 years ago, in 2015,